Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. There's nothing that says simple country comfort better and summing up a meal than my rice pudding. Let's get started right away. I have here 3/4 of a cup of rice that's already been pre-blanched, pre-cooked. It's fully tender. And first thing I want to do is start to make the custard for the pudding. And I'll add in 1/3 of a cup of sugar, pure cane sugar, 1½ cups of regular milk, and let that dissolve. Now I want to be careful. I don't want to whip the sugar too much and the milk too much because I don't want to mix in air into the batter, because otherwise it has more of a tendency to curdle. Just 1/2 teaspoon of salt, just for a little flavor. Vanilla, about 1 teaspoon of vanilla. A pinch of cinnamon. And here's a real good tip you might want to try next time you're cooking with raisins or baking with raisins, is to plump your raisins. Now, raisins are a dried grape. So what happens with raisins is they become very, very hard. All you have to do is either microwave them for about 10 seconds in a little water just to make them swell up, or even use a little bit of hot water on the raisins and they'll become much more tender and plump when baking. So I'll put in my raisins. And now I'll begin to heat it up. Now the first part of heating up the custard, it kind of is okay on its own. It doesn't need much stirring. It definitely doesn't need any whipping. We just want the temperature of the batter to come up slightly. When the temperature of the batter comes up, then we can put our rice in and then continue making the pudding. So what I have here is 1 farm fresh egg. I'm just going to lightly break up the egg. And you notice I have some more milk. This isn't milk that I forgot to put in. It's actually something that's going to help me make the transition from the hot custard in here into the egg and the remaining milk. Okay, now it's coming up to temperature. Now you notice here I have a double boiler. It's not sitting directly over a flame. A lot of times when you cook with milk and you're going to be adding in eggs, making custards and creams, it's always a better idea to use a double boiler instead of going directly over the heat. And using a double boiler, the bowl only goes down that far and the water level is only about 2 inches, creating a little bit of a steam vapor. I'll add in all my rice now that the milk has begun to warm up. And when I say simple comfort, you know, there's so many different types of dishes that may come to mind. For example, for me, the simple comfort and country comfort was my Nana. I mean, she made probably the best rice pudding in the world. And I think a lot of the inspiration even from this recipe and this technique did come from her. So I'm letting it all come to temperature. And what I want to do is as soon as it starts to have kind of a little bit of a steam vapor come off the rice and the milk, then I can make the liaison with the egg and the remaining milk. Okay, we'll start to warm up the egg and the milk by putting in some of the warm milk and rice, tempering the egg and the milk, and then pour all the remaining in. Now you can see it's looking a little bit more yellow or the color that you might be familiar with a rice pudding. And this part, you don't have to keep whipping it or stirring it too much because you don't want too much air to go into the pudding. You can see now the pudding is starting to thicken up. It's starting to resemble the characteristic of a pudding. Okay, now that it's nicely thickened and turned into a really good pudding, it's ready to come off. And we'll pour it back into our casserole. And rice pudding is really delicious, eaten hot, but it's even better when it has a chance to chill down. We can sprinkle a small amount of cinnamon on it and even put a little dollop of butter on top. There's nothing that says country comfort better than a little warm rice pudding. Oh, Nana would be so proud.
My creamy rice pudding for dessert.
If I can do it, you can do it. We'll see you real soon. Really good. Really, really good.
For more on recipes, entertaining lifestyle tips, TV series blog, and selected video clips from today's show, join me at ChefGeorgeHirsch.com.